Happy birthday to the King of Rock, DMC from Run DMC. X-Man 1991 back again with another video. Before I get this Attitude Era rant started, I got some really bad news. Some real shit. First off, I want to say I'm sending my condolences and prayers to Master P, Romeo, Silk the Shocker, C-Murder, and the rest of the Miller family, because Master P's daughter, Romeo's little sister, Silk the Shocker, and C-Murder's niece, Tatiana Miller, just passed away. I think she passed away over the weekend, and she was only 29. The cause of her death is unknown at this time. You've probably seen Tatiana Miller in the show Growing Up Hip Hop in 2016, where she documented her struggle with substance abuse. This is what Master P wrote on his Instagram. Hold on. Give me a moment here. This is what Master P wrote on his Instagram. Our family is dealing with an overwhelming grief for the loss of my daughter, Tatiana. We respectfully request some privacy so that our family can grieve. We appreciate all of the prayers, love, and support. Mental illness and substance abuse is a real issue that we can't be afraid to talk about. With God, we will get through this. Hashtag my angel. Romeo said the same thing on his IG too. Hold on. I feel bad for Master P and the Miller family. All right, this is what Romeo said on his IG. Pretty much the same thing. Our family is dealing with an overwhelming grief for the loss of my little sister, Tatiana. We respectfully request some privacy so that our family can grieve. We appreciate all of the prayers, love, and support. And although this is sad times, I'm forever grateful for the memories I did have with my amazing sister. Love on your loved ones. Life is short. The silver lining, I know she is in a way better place and finally at peace. God bless. R.M. Oh, man. Feel bad for the Miller family. I really feel bad for them. I could tell what they've been going through. Master P lost his brother, Kevin Miller, in 1990. 32 years later, he loses his daughter. So like I said, my thoughts and prayers goes to Master P, Romeo, Silk the Shocker, C-Murder, and the rest of the Miller family. The times that we're living in right now is complete bullshit. Now that we got that out the way, today's been 24 years since the 1998 WWF Over the Edge In Your House aired on pay-per-view. This pay-per-view took place at the Wisconsin Center Arena in Milwaukee. 8 matches were contested at the event. So before I show y'all the highlights, let's go ahead and read all the matches of this pay-per-view. Okay. The first match was a tag team match. The late Road Warriors, Hawk and Animal, known as LOD 2000, versus the Disciples of Apocalypse. Steve Blackman versus Jeff Jarrett. Sable versus Mark Miro. Kai and Tai versus Justin Brashaw and Taka Michinoku. An Intercontinental Championship match. The Rock versus Ron Simmons. A mask versus mask match. Vader versus Kane. A six-man tag team match. D-Generation X versus The Nation. And the main event. A Falls Count Anywhere match for the WWF Championship. Stone Cold Steve Austin versus Mick Foley as Dude Love. With Vince McMahon as the special guest referee. Pat Patterson as the special guest ring announcer. Gerald Briscoe as the special guest timekeeper. And The Undertaker as the special guest enforcer. All right, now I can show you all the highlights of the 1998 Over the Edge In Your House pay-per-view. Alright, I found it. If I don't get my 2 cents at the end of this video, then I'll catch you tomorrow for my reaction to game one of the 1997 finals between the Utah Jazz and the Chicago Bulls. But before I show y'all the highlights, I gotta end the video like this. If you smell what The Rock is cooking. And that's the bottom line, because Stone Cold said so. And now, here's highlights of the 1998 WWF Over the Edge In Your House pay-per-view. I'm gonna make it out. I'm gonna make it out.
Exactly want us to know what they're...